Hi, welcome to my first video. My name is YZ. I'm starting a YouTube channel to talk about my Jeep JL Wrangler. I ordered my Jeep directly from the manufacturer when it was first released back in November 2017. And for the past couple of years, I have learned so much about this vehicle. Things like why it's cheaper to custom order from the manufacturing comparing to directly buying from dealer's lot. How to qualify for additional rebates after you make the purchase, and all the issues that I have had with the early production models, as well as the recalls, but most importantly, things that I really like about my vehicle and how to make it my own. And that inspired me to create this YouTube channel to talk about all the modifications I have, everything that I learned about my Jeep, and share that information with you, and I hope that someone would find this helpful. Okay, let's get to it. If you recently bought a Jeep Wrangler, you would want to start with some easy modifications to give your Jeep some character and make it your own. Today I'm going to show you the top 5 easy DIY mods that everybody can do. Okay, number 1. Decals and all cosmetics on the exterior. I'm going to group a bunch of small items together, all under this one. The decals on the side of the hood. This is a must-have for all the Wranglers. For sports and Sahara models, which doesn't have anything on here, you have the opportunity to be very creative and have a lot of fun with customizing names or graphics. I just went with good Wrangler on here, and I don't think they can go wrong. Okay, one thing that I wouldn't do is put a Rubicon decals on here for your sports and Sahara models, because they're not a Rubicon model. There's also a big decal on top of the hood. This one is actually very functional. It reduced the sun glares of the hood, and I love the 1941 print. This is a great way to recognize and salute to Jeep's heritage. And moving down to the side. And this is a side decal on the vent. It doesn't do anything except for just adding 15 horsepower. No, it doesn't. Okay, and sorry for the background noise, guys. My neighbors are mowing. And moving down to the front. To the front of the Jeep, you guys will see the grille insert on here. I love the contrast from Rubicon and Sahara models. But the sports one is really boring, just the body color. So the black insert makes a big difference. Right, it's very easy to put it on, just double-sided tape. One thing that I didn't do a perfect job is if I move to the side a little bit, you guys can actually see some of the gaps right here, right? So see some of the gaps, it didn't push the inserts all the way. But that's very easy to fix, right? So a little plus the dip to cover up those areas, that would be perfect. And speaking of plus the dip, so moving down to this side. So as you guys can see, this one, I make this a black color. I plus the dip the Jeep on here. And also my antenna. So not sure if you guys can see this well. Sorry. So the antenna, a lot of other Jeep owners, they would change to shorter, stubby antennas. I keep this one the manufacturer size, but I just plus the dip to the black color, which I really like the contrast. And one problem I have with this is, let me zoom in, focus on here, it's really, you see it's starting to strip off at the base. That's because the antenna is really twisted onto the base, and that twisting motion you gave to the plastic dip, it actually stripped that off, right? But I think the regular black pin would also do the job instead of plastic dip. Okay, and the next one is removing the sports bumper gap cover. So if you guys own a sports model, you wouldn't know what I'm talking about. It's that piece right here. That piece right here that connects the fender and the bumper, which I don't know why it doesn't have any purposes. I hate the look. So I removed that piece, And one thing to keep in mind is after you remove that piece, you would leave the fog light housing completely exposed. So I just cut off the back cover and put the back cover on there. So this looks much cleaner, and it has the back piece would actually protect my fog light housings. That bumper piece is really easy to cut. It's just soft plastic. You can actually just use a utility knife to cut it through. Okay, and you guys might notice the yellow film that I have on my turn signals, the fog light, and the auxiliary lights that I put it on there. The yellow color would make it so easy to cut through the rain, the snow, the foggy conditions, and make it much easier for us to see. Okay, so everything I talk about is really just the easy DIY item number one, right? Just the cosmetics. Okay, and now let's move to item number two. The LED highlights is an excellent upgrade if you are still running the standard halogen lights. The LED shines much brighter and projects much farther down the road. The size of the JL stock highlight unit is 9 inches, which is a bit larger than the 7-inch unit from the JK models. There are a lot of options on aftermarket 7-inch LEDs out there, and they're very reasonably priced. I see some JL owners put LED bulbs in their halogen housing when the JL was first released, and this is not ideal. That's probably because the aftermarket hasn't fully caught up to speed on the highlight adapters for the 7 inches. But right now it's very easy to retrofit a 7 inch LED into the JL with an adapter like this. And interestingly enough, the size of the JL highlight union diameter is still 7 inches. Just the union with the plastic housing is larger than the JK's. So if you retrofit a 7-inch into a JL, it doesn't mean you put in a smaller headlight. The surface area is the same. I'm running the 7-inch with no issues. You won't notice any gaps between my headlights and the grills. I also wired in a daytime running light. It turns on automatically when your Jeep is on. I will make another video to show you guys how everything is wired together. Okay, item number three, the Duracell guards, which is this little guy right here. The Duracell guards adds protection to your Duracell, so make sure you are not scratching up the pin on the Duracell area when you're getting in and out of your Jeep. There are a lot of options available. Essentially, this is just a piece of plastic with double-sided tape on the back. If you can find a generic one for $30, you know, don't pay $80 for Mopar ones. Alright, next one is the grab handles. They work really well to help you get in and out of your Jeep, especially if you are adding a lift kit or running on larger tires. There are a lot of options available on the market, since you can choose from a variety of colors to match your Jeep. Plus, they are super easy to install, and I also add two more. And I also add two more of these attached to my front seat. And my kids actually use this one to get in and out of his car seat every day. Okay, next one is the Mopar all-weather floor mat. This is a must-have. It fits perfectly, it locks into the floor, and also gave you the access to the drain hole. You can actually hose this off after day from muddy trails or a sandy beach. This is an item that I would purchase from Mopar. Other brands might have fitment issues or no drain hole access. The Mopar ones have red lighting on here, which gives a great contrast. I ordered mine as an add-on from the manufacturer, so I have the black letters, and additionally, it didn't come with standard carpets. So for the same price, you know, make sure you don't order this from the manufacturer together with your Jeep. You can pick up a set from Amazon or buy at your dealer afterward. Okay, there you have it, the top 5 easy DIY mods for JL Wrangler that everybody can do. And I will include a product link for every single item that I talk about in today's video in the description box below. For my next video, I'm planning to go over all the LED upgrades I have. Well, I hope you guys like this video. If you found it helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to my channel. And also comment below if you guys like me to make a video on anything else that you see on my Jeep. Okay, thanks for watching. See you next time.